Welcome back to EPT 11 in Barcelona. It's day 1B and I found Mr. Daniel Negreanu to talk a little bit about what he said on Twitter recently. Daniel, you said you are able to be 2550 online. What's the story?
See, you, just like everybody else, can't read. Apparently, your reading comprehension is the problem. First of all, I'm going to go a little history here. So it's all sort of some guy calling me adult, right? And sometimes on Twitter, people mess with me, so I give it back to him. You know what I'm saying? And I mess with this guy. So basically what I said to him was like, well, eventually I finally said that I believe I could beat it, right? And I'd bet $1 million on it. That's not saying I was a challenge to the world. It was an at reply. It wasn't like, hello, Twitter world. I'm looking to play this big match for $1 million and leave my home for 3 months and maybe win. I believe I could do it. It's not stating a fact. I believe if I put the work in that I could. I could be completely wrong and I'm open to that. But I also just have a lot of belief in myself. So the issue is it's not going to happen anytime soon because I'm not leaving my home in Las Vegas for 3 months to do this. And that would require, you know, roughly around that much time.
Even though you didn't put it out there as a challenge, people were responding to it and also judging whether or not you could do it. What makes you think you can do it if it ever becomes a challenge?
Well, there's a few things. I have one trick up my sleeve, which I won't mention publicly. But aside from that, is I have friends that are some of the best, you know, high stakes known players online. They could help me. I've always been a numbers geek and a stats guy, so that's something that really plays into my hands. I've succeeded in forms before. It's not like I'm starting from scratch. You know, it's not like I'm like, oh wow, hold 'em. We get two cards. What happens after that? And I want to make one thing clear. You know, the fact that I said I could likely be competitive within 2 weeks, that's not a slant on all the guys who put in a lot of work. And if they took it that way and I offended them, I apologize. Like, I really didn't mean to offend those that put in the hard work. And I realize how difficult it is. I'm just the guy who has a lot of belief in myself. And like I said, it's not like I'm starting from scratch. So I feel like 2 weeks as a primer might get me to a place where, like, I'm a slight loser, right? Mm-hmm. And then, you know, by the time we get to whatever hands we bet, that I could get to, you know, ahead and then winner. So it's not that after 2 weeks I'd be all of a sudden be, you know, the king. And I would also game select pretty hard.
Canu was one of the guys you reached out to, Team PokerStars Online. You said maybe to get some coaching. What would be some of the things you would have to work on, you think, if you were going to jump into these games?
Well, fundamentally, you know, just like a number, you know, just some of the fundamentals. Because obviously, you know, and one thing I realized is that I am out of touch with, because I did this in 2010, where I took on this challenge and I really, not just for myself, and I learned to adapt, but according to a lot of people I've been talking to, the game's gotten to another level. And people playing Game Theory Optimal, and they're really balancing their range as well. So, you know, getting into the understanding of that. But most of it is going to come from me looking at the way they're playing and then asking questions, asking the right people some questions about what am I missing here? What do I need to be doing here? And again, you know, I know the poker world would love to see it, you know, but what they're missing too is, like, I love my life. You know, I really love my life. And the idea of, like, leaving home for 3 months to do this, you know, everyone's like, well, you wouldn't leave home for 3 months for $3 million? I'm like, I don't just get to win. You know, it's not like guaranteed $5 million if you just go away for 3 months. I could lose too. So it's not something on my radar. But once legislation happens in the United States and I'm able to play from Las Vegas, I promise I will give those boys some action.
Yeah, Doc Polk basically openly challenged you in the video that I did with him earlier. Mm-hmm. He said, of course, stipulations and kind of like sample size. Have you thought of what you need and what you would want for that kind of challenge?
Well, see, that's the thing. It's like, you know, I said I could beat it. Well, what's the definition of beating it? You know, and Daniel Coleman asked me the same question. It's like, there's no terms. There's no, like, well, how many hands is it? You know, if you guys want to, okay, I'll play one session, 50 hands. We'll see. You guys want to, you know, like, it could be, there'd be so many stipulations of what you'd have to come to. And there's a lot of sticky situations in terms of game selecting. The one good thing that's come of this for me is I've become aware of what seat scripting is and how big of a problem that is for the high stakes game. So whether I'm, you know, not just for myself personally, but I'd like to see, you know, a change to that, because I think it's a really sort of bad precedent to set. You know, let's say a bad player sits down, all of a sudden, boom, game's full. I'd like to see some things done about that. And I believe that there's got to be, and I don't know enough about this stuff, but I believe there's got to be a way to address it. Mm-hmm.
One final thing, and we might be getting a little bit off topic when it comes to just beating those games, but things like using a tracking software and seed scripting, would you be an advocate to get rid of all that stuff?
Well, of course. You know, it changes the game. Having said that, tracking software, it's impossible to get rid of that, because for one, I mean, you know, you can go to the simplest form. Someone could actually, you know, put pencil to paper and write down everything that's happening. But I've talked to some other guys and they go, if the guy's willing to do that, man, he deserves it, right? But, you know, I don't think tracking software is going anywhere. I think Zoom helps to prevent, you know, the ability to really use it effectively. Having said that, at the very highest levels, I believe that the HUDs are less important. If you're playing with the same group of players, you're going to be maybe being based on history and stuff that most of the top minds, I think, innately understand.
Well, Daniel Negreanu will be ready for the challenge as soon as PokerStars comes back to Nevada.
I didn't issue a damn challenge!
But you said you were ready.
Yeah, well, when it comes back to Nevada, I'll do something with y'all, okay? Promise. Scout's honor. I'm a man of my word, man of integrity.
Let's keep it at that. Stay tuned to PokerStars.com for more coverage at EPT 11 right here in Barcelona.